everyone, it's Justin again. I've been working with my friend Jordan on a project, but we're having some trouble, so I'm hoping that you can help us out. See, Jordan is adopting a pair of guinea pigs. Their names are Bacon and Eggs, and they're best friends. Jordan wants to give them the best home possible. So she wants to get an enclosure set up in her living room where they can have space to roam around without getting into anything dangerous. She has 20 feet of little fencing to use to set up the perimeter. And she doesn't have a ton of space, so she needs it to be 6 feet wide. The trouble is that we can't figure out how long it needs to be to make a nice rectangle and use all of the fencing. Luckily for us, I think that the topic we're learning about today is going to be a big help. Let's get into it. Today, we are going to be talking about literal equations, which is just a fancy way of saying equations with more than one variable. A lot of math, science, and engineering formulas are set up with one variable isolated. For example, for the guinea pig enclosure, we'll need the formula for the perimeter of a rectangle, which is P equals 2L plus 2W. L and W represent the length and width of the rectangle, and P, which represents the total perimeter, is by itself. But sometimes that's not the variable we're trying to find. With Jordan, we already know that the perimeter is going to be 20 feet. And we know that the width is 6 feet. So what we need to find is L, not P. When we run into situations like this, we can just solve the formula for whichever variable we need. Let's take a look at it together to see what that looks like. Now, we have a literal equation here that we want to solve for L. You have all of the skills that you need to solve this, but if you're a little intimidated by the extra variables, that's totally okay. We can always go way back to our equation solving roots and dust off our old organizer. What is happening to the L in this equation? Thinking about the order of operations, first it's being multiplied by 2, and then 2w is being added to that. So to isolate L, we're going to undo those operations with their opposites in the reverse order, starting with subtracting 2w from both sides and then dividing both sides by 2. Pause the video here and give this a try on your own. When I subtract 2w from both sides, I can see that on the right, 2w minus itself cancels out, leaving just 2l. But what about on the left? What does p minus 2w make? Well, they're not like terms because they have different variables, so we can't just combine them. This is actually just going to stay as p minus 2w. Now, to get rid of the coefficient in front of the L, I can divide both sides by 2, and I need to be careful here and make sure that I divide the whole left side by 2. Now, this leaves L by itself. Can I do anything to simplify this big fraction on the left? Think back to what you learned about simplifying expressions. What can we still do here? We can distribute this division and actually divide each of these terms by 2. Then what will they look like? Well, p divided by 2 will just make p over 2, and negative 2w divided by 2 leaves just minus w. So our final, fully simplified answer is that p over 2 minus w equals L. Since distributing the division actually lets us simplify the coefficient of w, our equation wasn't fully simplified until we did it. Since our answer isn't just a single number, keep in mind that there will often be multiple ways that you can write it out. For example,
Could I rearrange this left side of my solution at all to write it differently? Yeah, we could swap our terms and write it as negative w plus p over 2, if we wanted to. These two versions mean the exact same thing, and either would be a perfectly acceptable final answer. Now that we know what to expect with literal equations, let's do two more example problems. This first example problem says to solve for m, and the equation says k equals mv squared over 2. I want you to try this one on your own first, so pause the video here and give it a shot. If you're having trouble, try thinking back to our two question structure. What is happening to m right now in this equation? Since it's next to that v squared, it's being multiplied by v squared. And that fraction bar tells us that then the product is being divided by 2. If you were stuck before, now is a great time to pause the video again and try to finish this off on your own. To isolate m, I'm going to undo these operations with their opposites, in the reverse order, starting with getting rid of that 2 in the denominator by multiplying both sides by 2. On the right, the 2s cancel, leaving just mv squared. On the right, 2 times k makes 2k. Now it's time to get rid of that v squared. Does it matter that the v is being squared? Nope. All that we care about is that it's being multiplied times m, and we don't want it to be multiplied times m anymore. Just like we would undo any other multiplication, we'll divide both sides by that v squared. On the right, the v squared over v squared will cancel, leaving just m. And on the left, I have 2k over v squared. Is there anything I can simplify here? Nope, there isn't. And since there is no addition or subtraction, that means the numerator is one single term, and I can't distribute the division at all. There is no way that this can be rearranged. So this is our final answer. Our second example problem says to solve for t, and we have the equation below. There's something different looking in this equation that I want to talk about. Does anything stand out to you? This zero below the v is called a subscript, and it acts as a label. So this term is called v0. Subscripts are a way that we can label values that are different, but often related to each other. This equation right here is actually used in physics, and v and v0 each represent different velocities or speeds of an object. And since they represent different speeds, they are not like terms. You may remember seeing subscripts back when you learned about slope with this formula. The same thing is happening here. y2 and y1 represent different y coordinates, so they're not like terms that can be combined at all. And the same with x2 and x1. Now that we know what's going on with this notation, pause the video here and try to solve for t on your own. To isolate the t, I need to undo everything that's happening to it. I can use my two question organizer to help me. Right now, it's being multiplied by a, and then v0 is being added to that. So we'll undo those with the opposite operations in the reverse order. I'll start by subtracting v0 from both sides. On the right, v0 minus v0 cancels, leaving at. On the left, what's v minus v0? Remember, these are not like terms, so we can't combine them. This is just going to stay as v minus v0. Now all that's left is to get rid of the a to get to the t by itself. So how can I do that? Since a is being multiplied by t, we can divide both sides by a to undo it. This leaves the t by itself on the right. Can I simplify anything on the left? Not really. This is a perfectly good final answer. If you want, you can distribute this division to both terms to get v over a minus v0 over a, and this would be another way to write your final answer, and either would be acceptable. But since distributing that division doesn't actually cancel anything or simplify any terms, we don't have to. You may also swap the placement of v and v0 as long as you keep the v0 term negative and the v term positive.
Keep in mind that all of the strategies you've been using for solving equations still apply when there are multiple variables in the equation. We're just about done with our lesson video, but make sure that you take a look through your PDF to finalize your guided notes and check out some of the bonus opportunities in there. After all, we still need to figure out how long Jordan's guinea pig enclosure needs to be. Then you'll move on to your practice game. Make sure you're looking at all of the answers carefully to be on the lookout for anything that might look different from your work, but that's still equivalent. Good luck, and I'll see you next time.